Okay. I have to be open. So, okay. If you guys, not if, a lot of you do. Morning, guys. Happy Tuesday. I hope everybody had an awesome Tuesday. Today is March 21st, and I am up early. I don't even need to look at the time. I already know I'm up early. What is it? 8:53. It's almost 9 o'clock. I gotta go to the NBA because my license expires on the 27th. And that's illegal to drive with an expired license. So I'm just gonna go pay my 40-something bucks, get that taken care of, and hopefully I'm not at the NBA all day. There's a reason why I'm going there this early. Hopefully not. Really wish we just had something like, something I could just grab and go. But we don't. I have to make something, and I don't have time for that. But I don't want to starve at the NBA. They need to have like an NBA. Oops, sorry. They need to have like an NBA, I don't know, coffee bar or something there. I don't know. Because the last time I was at the NBA, they didn't hold me there too long. I was there for like maybe an hour, hour and a half. But I'm afraid they're going to hold me long this time, so I want to get something, but. Apple. Here we go. That's what I'm gonna get. This car out yesterday. Ooh, it's looking great. Man, it's probably gonna smell great too. Come on, keys. Cause I waxed it and everything. Cleaned the stupid leather seats. Smells fresh. Oh my gosh. Okay. Yep, this is a clean car. I'm loving this. Yep. As a matter of fact, this car was so dirty, I couldn't even get every single last piece of dirt up like what I wanted. But I sure did get a lot of it up. Man, it's looking good. Love riding around a clean car. But I have to be open with you guys for just a second. I have to be open. So, okay. If you guys, not if, a lot of you do. I know a lot of you follow me on like Snapchat for sure, because I see you. And Twitter. Luckily, you don't follow me on Facebook. But, okay. Snapchat and Twitter. Two main problems. If you saw me post some depressed-sounding stuff over the last few days, I apologize for that. That's not how I usually am. If you follow me on those areas, you're not gonna see like a bunch of sad stuff, okay? It's just that the last few days have been kind of rough because something happened a week ago, maybe even 2 weeks ago. I put something on Twitter. I'm not even gonna say what I put because I don't want to talk about it anymore, but I put something on Twitter. I thought everybody was gonna react nicely and say congratulations. Everybody did not react like that, and then I'm put on the spot for something that I don't want to be put on the spot for, and now it's negative. And I was unhappy about that. So then I delete the tweet. I'm just like, okay, y'all, leave me alone. And it gets brought back up again. And I'm like, oh my gosh. And now it's just stress from that. And then from school. And then from this thing that's happening on Sunday. And then this person said this. This person did this. And it's just all this stuff that's just kind of piling on top. And it makes like this mountain of just stress and despair. And it was frustrating. Especially yesterday. But I'm not going to be upset about that anymore because I already prayed on that. So it's like, it really isn't anything that I have to be upset over. So I don't even know why I was upset, but I don't know. I'm a very emotional person. But I have decided to do some things. I have my Twitter and my Facebook linked so that whatever I tweet, it goes to Facebook. So I had to like de-link that another time because a lot of people on Facebook were like, and I really don't want to put anybody on the spot, so I'm not, but like a lot of people on Facebook were like saying what I was posting, going informing other people what I was posting, and then my mom and dad find out, and then they're giving me a lecture. I had to hear a lecture from mom yesterday. I had to hear a lecture from dad yesterday. And it's like, when you get married, you're supposed to become one. Two becomes one. So why am I hearing two lectures? Come on, it's supposed to be one lecture. But basically what I decided, I'm probably going to go back and de-link my Facebook so that the people on Facebook who I feel as though are being a little bit too nosy and are just trying to find bad stuff that I'm doing, you know, they won't see it anymore. And I do overall need to post less. I feel as though I've been posting too much stuff on Facebook, too much stuff on Twitter. That was a speech my dad gave me. You know, I have to learn, you know, when I have to learn to be wise, which is what I prayed about last night. Like, you know, I guess I need some more wisdom because I need to, like, be able to differentiate what I should post and what I shouldn't post. Because I thought what I did post was okay, but obviously it's not because people are helping over it. And I'm going to come out and say this. Yes, I'm getting baptized on Sunday. A lot of you guys know that. No, I'm not posting a video on it. I wanted to post a video on it. I wanted to talk about it. I wanted to talk about the entire process. I wanted to do that. But I can't do that anymore because that's going to... Obviously, that bugs people, okay? So, yeah, I'm not going to do it. Maybe I'll post it sometime in the future. I'm still going to record it. Hopefully, it's recorded. But I can't. I'm not putting it on this platform. I'm not putting it on my Facebook platform. I will tweet it. Got baptized. But that's it. Mm-mm. Because I just don't want any more drama. Like, it's stressful enough having to, like, deal with people. And then it's yeah. So I apologize if you did want to see it and you did want to hear about it. Because I'm not putting anything on that on this channel. Because I don't want some people to see it. And I was, like, extra excited about it. But now it's just like... Oh my gosh. Man. Sorry that the first part of this vlog is going to be kind of depressing, but it's upsetting because it's like, people don't understand that some churches just do things differently, and there's nothing wrong with that. Like, there are like so many different denominations. There's, you know, Baptists, and there's Pentecostal, and there's the Apostolics, and there's Church of Christ, and there's Lutheran, and they all teach a little different, and they all do things a little different. But all that matters is that we're all trying to spend eternal life with Christ in heaven, but people don't see it like that. It's just, it's frustrating. People just, it's so judgmental and just, I'm not going to continue ranting on this because you guys are already tired of hearing about it, and I understand. The rest of this vlog is going to be happy, but I just had to get that off my chest because the best way I know to get, the best way I know to get stuff off my chest is by crying, which I'm trying to work on. And then I can talk to this camera. This camera is the easiest, one of the easiest things for me to talk to. It's easy for me to talk to guys, easy for me to talk to this camera. Actual people, I need some help with that. But, okay, depressing stuff over. How are y'all doing today? You know, let's start off a conversation in the comments, you know. How are y'all doing? And if you guys go to church, what church do you guys go to? Tell me more about it. Because I'm very open to hear stuff, you know. I'm not judgmental. I'll see you guys at the end. If I could give one piece of advice to you guys, it would be to watch what you put on this internet, okay? And it gets hard for me because I have a YouTube channel, this channel that you guys are looking at right now. And, you know, I have Twitter, Snapchat, Instagram, all that fun stuff. So it's like, it gets a little bit difficult. Oop, I'm sorry, y'all. It gets a little bit difficult to watch what I put on the internet because it's like, this is why I prayed for wisdom last night, because it's just, I gotta just watch it. So, you know, I know a lot of celebrities and everybody who gets in trouble for putting stuff on the internet that they shouldn't do. So it's not like it's just me. People go through it all the time, but it's just, it gets tiring, you know? Especially since people will not forget something you said that was negative. Who cares about all the positive stuff you put on the internet? One little negative thing? And it's sad, and I really can't have those kind of people in my life, but you know. Alright, no more negativity for the rest of this vlog. No more. I'm almost to the NBA. I'm just riding behind a garbage truck. I hope this NBA don't have a bunch of people there, because I'm assuming all of y'all should be at work, because it's Tuesday morning. But I'm wondering where all of y'all going, because... Let me stop. I lied. It is a bunch of people here, and I'm in the back. It is a bunch of people parked over there, so let me just hurry up and get in here. Let's play a game, y'all. How long do you think I'm going to be in the NBA? It's 9:15. My guess is 2 hours. I'll see you guys at 11:15. What's y'all's guess? Okay, I was out in 1 hour and 15 minutes, because it is 10:30 right now, so 10:30. 9:30, 9:15, 10:15. An hour and 15 minutes, not too bad. Man, and I saw like I saw a friend in there, so we were chatting. Shout out to Diana if you watch my videos, which you probably don't. But okay, it cost me $50. I thought it was gonna cost me $40. Cause I got it renewed and then it says conversion. So well, this is my temporary license. Just gonna stick that in my bag. And then, yeah, it's 10:30, so I have a little bit of time. Let me text my friend Jasmine and see if she wants me to bring her the money. Because we're doing something in like 2 weeks, 3 weeks. It's a secret though. You gotta keep watching to find out. But alright, let me text her and see if she's up. If so, then I'll just bring my money right on by before I head home. Yeah, I went 15 minutes. That wasn't bad. Okay, so I am home and I am about to, I got a new debit credit thing card in the mail. So I tried to activate it at the actual machine, but it didn't let me. So now I have to go through all this stuff they gave me and figure out how to activate it. Cause it's so cute. I've never had like a personalized card before and this is personalized. So it's so cute. I love it. But that last vlog I posted about when I went to Baltimore and stuff, a chunk of the vlog actually I didn't get to put in there because I accidentally recorded it in the AVCHD format and that isn't recognized by iMovie and it wasn't recognized by Movie Maker, so chunk of the vlog actually wasn't in there. So let's have a story time. This is the story of when I went to Wendy's in Baltimore on what's that road called? Not Harvard Road, it can't be Hartford Road. Yeah, I'm shouting you out, cause let's have a chat. So I went into the Wendy's, that's where we went for lunch. We had a choice of going to Wendy's, could have gone to Mickey D's, could have gone to Subway. I chose to go to Wendy's and we were right there. So I go inside, and we're waiting in line for like 20 hours. Oh my gosh, that cashier was moving so painfully slow. Oh my gosh. She was moving so slow. I've never stood in a fast food line where they were moving this slow. Like, I can be patient, but you're moving slow. And then there was this lady who was behind me. Let me tell y'all one of my pet peeves. I have a lot of them. Let me tell you one of them. If I'm standing right here in line and you're right here, this is a problem, right? Because somebody was doing this to me in the Dollar Tree. Stop standing so just close to me. Back all the way up. And she was kind of, like I was right here, she would be right here, and then she would move like here, then I would move here, and I'm trying to give her a hint like, can you back up? She was acting like she wanted to rush and get around me and get her food first. It's like, no, stop. But by the time I finally get up to the cashier lady, her slow acting self, I get my order put in. This lady who's behind me, she's still just right up on me. I'm like, oh my gosh. This is another reason why I can't commute to Baltimore. Not if all y'all acting like that. I'm just joking. But, so I get my food and then I wait another 20 hours for them to actually give me my food. And then I have to wait another 20 hours for me to get my little junior frosty. And then I have to wait another 20 hours for them to give me some honey mustard sauce because they didn't put it in the bag. And they're just moving so slow, which is why I'm thinking about it. I need to come over here and ride a yelp with you. All while that lady, she's still up on my butt. And she gets her food, she goes and sits down. She comes back up there because I got the order wrong. And she goes back and sit down. And she's just, I don't know. I just wanted her to just go, you know, like go somewhere else. Gosh. And it was funny because she was being so phony. It was this other lady that I guess she was trying to not show off around. But it was this other lady there and they were kind of having a conversation, like this older lady. And then the lady who was right up on my butt, she was having grace with her kid. She was like, okay, you guys, come on, let's say grace. And they said a very loud grace. And I was like, okay, stop being phony. Now, you know if that older lady was not looking, y'all wouldn't have been saying no grace. I don't know. I have a thing about stuff like that. I got a thing about stuff like that. But, yeah, let me come on here and write this review because I write reviews. Okay, I'm a Yelper. So if I go to a business and they have excellent service, I'm gonna come on here and say it. If it's terrible, come on here and say it. But alright, I'll catch you guys a little bit later. It's almost 11:30. I'm gonna leave out the house at like 12:30 to go up to the Wegmans. meet my friend, church. So, I've just been sitting here just studying some older sermons. Because I take notes during church. I'm just studying some of these older sermons and I pasted them into my journal. But it's 12:08. I'm going to leave for Wegmans at 12:30. But I do want to go on here and look at my statistics grade. Because like I said in an older vlog, it's not bad. But it's not where I want it to be, you see. So we took a quiz yesterday. And he's only going to take the top 8 quizzes. So I have a feeling I did good. But let's go see. And we have another quiz tomorrow, which is good. Alright. Oh, okay. Because my grade dropped a point. So I'm thinking I did bad on that quiz, but no. Here's why I dropped. I started homework 7A, but I didn't finish it, but it's not due until the 27th. So it recorded that as me not have completed it. Like, I got 6 out of 12, so that's why my grade dropped. Okay, all right, we're still good, y'all. But he didn't post quiz. He didn't post the last quiz. I'll just be patient, I guess. That's fine. What day is it today? The 20th? 21st? We took the quiz yesterday on the 20th. Okay. I'll wait. Let's see. We got the quiz tomorrow on chapter 3C. Ignore me. 6C. Alright. Okay, so I did good on it, but let me see if this is something I struggled with. Overall, I like stat. It's just, I don't know. I like it when I get it, but I have to really get it. Like, I don't know. Let's see. X binomial distribution. Okay, I can use a calculator for this. I think all of this I get. Yeah, I pretty much get it. The trick is, I'm using my stat lab for this. So the trick to make sure I get good grades on like the tests and quizzes is do the homework all over again. Without pushing question help me solve this. If I can answer all these questions without clicking on help me solve this, then that's how I know I got it. But alright, it's 12:12. Wow, time's just moving. Alright, I'm gonna go talk to my dad for like a few minutes and then head on out the door.
Bro, why can't some dorms look like this? I wouldn't be having this issue about, you know, dorms and stuff if they all just look like that. Nice. Well, why is the fire truck at Wegmans, are we having a fire? It doesn't look like it. Okay, but there's a full-on fire truck at Wegmans. I'm not even kidding about this. It's a full-on fire truck. I am not even kidding about this when I say it's a full-on fire truck at Wegmans. What is going on? And why did I park next to this guy? He parked like all the way on the line. I keep parking next to people who can't park themselves. Ugh, what's going on?
Hey, ambulance, fire truck, but for real, what is going on?
Selfish, just watching them take the patient from the Wegmans, put her in the ambulance. It looks like it might have been asthma. It looks like she had an asthma attack or something. But she's gonna be fine, it looks like it.
I'm so nosy for real, but stuff like this really interests me. Like, I used to watch this show growing up. It was called Rescue 911. It was all about this type of stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, she's all right.
Okay, so I just left my meeting with Danielle. She's my friend from a church. Our pastor introduced us, and she's awesome, you know? I was talking to her about some stuff, and now some things are cleared up. That's all I'm gonna say. But now I'm headed to school because there's this speech lecture thing that's going on at school that I said I want to listen to. So I'm gonna go listen to that. And I do not want to drive with salad on the top of my car, so let me go get that. Ah, here we go. That would have been dangerous. But all right, it's kind of warm. Kind of warm. Oh my gosh. I feel as though I'm getting a headache for some reason. It's like I'm lightheaded or something. I'm not sure why I feel like this, but I'm about to head to school.
And yes, I will see you guys there.
Here at school. Oh my gosh.
And I looked up. I got a parking space like right in front.
Man,
I am right in front. And look at this. I could have gotten closer. You see that? Could have gotten even closer. Wow. So, it is not 2:30 just yet. What time is it? It's 2:09, so I'm going to sit in the car for a little bit because I just feel like I need to go somewhere and take a nap. Oh my gosh. Why do I have this, like, it's not even so much a headache as it is, like, this pressure just right here. It'll be around my eye sockets. But I remember what I wanted to talk to y'all about earlier. When I go away to school, what I want to do is I think, thanks to my friends who planted this thought in my mind, because I was not thinking about this until they talked to me about it, which is why it's important to have, you know, good friends. But anyways, something that I think I want to do is I want to pledge to a sorority. I know, right? Alexis, pledging to a sorority. Yes, I do. I think I want to do that. So when I tweeted a tweet and put it on my Facebook, I think I want to do a sorority, but I don't know which one. There's so many. Everybody who commented, basically, almost everyone, was like, oh, you seem like a Delta. You seem like a Delta. You seem like a Delta. And I'm like, do I seem like a Delta? So who more to ask than y'all? Because y'all will tell me, do I seem like a Delta? That's the question. Because honestly, I was looking at Delta, Sigma, Theta, of course, but I was also looking at Alpha, Kappa, Alpha, because that's like, whenever I think of a sorority, I always think AKA. That's just what I think of. So everybody was like, oh, you seem like a Delta, 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 Delta. So I looked in a Delta and I was like, okay, why do I seem like a Delta? Y'all let me know, right? It is spring, walking around in short sleeves, and it had better not get real cold. Let it be spring.
I cannot walk into this school without, who's calling? Not walk into the school without seeing someone who I know. That's what I like about smaller schools. It's like it's a community. It also gets kind of scary. Whew, almost there. I do like smaller schools.
Okay, so it's a lot of noise, but I'm here with the president.
Hi.
Look, it's president.
I'm not here, I'm here.
Oh, I think you were still in the frame. But I just finished this going to this lecture, the presentation series. It was really good. It made me feel very appreciative of what I have in my life. But now we're on a mission because we got to go get something printed. So, yeah, this is what we're doing right now. And I would be so happy when this construction is over. So happy. Okay, so now I'm recording because I'm about to say, since we're in this elevator, I thought we'd do Elevator Chronicles.
Like, what if it just, like,
no, I can't stand when y'all do that. You keep saying that. And, like, why would you say it in the elevator? Say
the elevator's
going out.
The elevator's going to open up.
And we're see? Walking out.
See? Exactly. That's so funny.
Guys, look, the prayer room is open. The prayer room.
I hope I caught everything that you were saying. I never pray in there. It's unlocked anyway.
Oh my gosh, it's my classmate right there. But okay, I'm done hanging out with President. And I was just saying to her, I think this headache came from the McDonald's I had this morning. I didn't vlog it, but I went to McDonald's for breakfast because I was right over there. Oh my gosh. All I got was a breakfast burrito, and that just messed my head up for the rest of the day. Oh my gosh. Yes, I'm all right, police officer. Oh my gosh. It's not even funny. Jeez, I need to go home and lay down, but I also got some homework to finish. Thank God my accounting professor extended the homework, and thank God the statistics homework isn't too hard and I can handle it. Whew. No. Man, my head is on fire. But alright, I'm about to head home, taking a nap.
Hey y'all, so I'm sitting here editing the vlog, and I realized I didn't finish it. I apologize for that. I must have went home. That nap was so good. Forgot the vlog. But, okay. it's a few days later, but we're just gonna pretend like, you know, this is in the vlog. Thank you guys. What in the world? Oh. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed yet, make sure you do that. Thumbs this video up. And I'll talk to you guys another day. Bye-bye.